Here's how you can complete your economics syllabus in 1 month. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Ananya. If you're new here, please subscribe. So continuing the series, I have already made videos on maths and accounts. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about economics. If you have been on my channel for a while, you know that I really enjoy the subject economics, and that's what I'm going to be pursuing in my undergraduation. So over the years of 11th and 12th, I've really found some good strategies that work for economics. And as per my experience, I feel like economics is a very easy subject and you can easily get a 40 on 40 if you study in the proper manner. Like, even though you're thinking right now ki mere se economics nahi hota hai, I'm sure after watching this video you will be able to get through economics so easily. So if you're excited for this video, then give it a thumbs up and let's get right into it. Now, first things first, as only about 1 month is left for your board exams, it's very important to study economics in an organized manner. Now, economics mein syllabus bahut zyada hota hai. You have macroeconomics, you have Indian economics, so there's a lot to study. So it's very important that you do it step by step. And right now, I'll tell you exactly how you should go about studying economics. So firstly, you have to read the chapters, and for that I was using the guide or reference book Sandeep Garg, both for macroeconomics as well as Indian economics. All the information is given in the Sandeep Garg. It is according to the NCERT. Everything is given in points, so it becomes very easy to remember all the syllabus. Honestly, you do not need to study anything else. Lucky for me, my economics teacher in school was so good that I used to understand everything in school. So I also had school notes to study for economics. But again, if you study the Sandeep Garg as well, tumhara ho jayega aaram se syllabus. Now, since there's 1 month, let's say for the first week you have to make sure that you're reading all your chapters at least once. So you can simply divide those chapters in 1 week and you can easily get done with reading that. Now, the next step after reading the chapter is very important, that is solving the back exercise of your guidebook, whichever you're using. So in Sandeep Garg, there were a lot of questions in the back exercise, especially one marker. So there were MCQs, fill in the blanks, true and false, etc. And all these one markers can be converted into MCQs. So it's very important to practice these one markers. So once you are done with reading the chapters as well as solving the back exercise, your 75% of the work is already done. Because I'm assuming तुम्हें ये पढ़ के chapter समझ में आ गया होगा and you've remembered everything as well. अब चलो, you have studied the syllabus back exercise, let's say एक या दो हफ्ते में you have finished it. Now it's very important to revise what you have already studied, and that's what's called active recalling. Basically, you are actively revising each and everything that you've learned over the previous week so that you don't forget it. And to revise the economics ka syllabus, I have found the most effective method, and that is of using flashcards. And I totally understand that just 1 month left, so nobody has the time to make their own flashcards, but lucky for you, I have found the perfect app that has inbuilt flashcards, and the app is called Flash Prep and it's completely free to use. So basically, Flash Prep is a study companion app, and it can be used by all students appearing for exams like the CBSE class 10 and class 12 exams, or even if you're appearing for JEE, NEET, UPSC, etc. Basically, this app has their own inbuilt flashcards that you can use to revise, practice and study for your board exams, or you can also make your own flashcards in the app. They also have various practice mock tests that you can use for your upcoming board exams, and you can also get insights on your learning. And I personally think flashcard is a much enjoyable way of studying. It helps you to stay consistent with your studies, which is I think a major problem among most of us, and it also helps you to revise the syllabus effectively. And as I've always said, practice as many questions as possible, and basically the Flash Prep app will help you to do exactly that. So this is what the Flash Prep app looks like. You simply have to choose whichever exam you're preparing for, and it will automatically suggest flashcards according to that. So in the search bar, you can basically search for any topic, chapter or subject, and it will automatically show the flashcards for that. And then you click on start, and there are a bunch of options like study using notes, study using flashcards, or practicing mock questions, or you can also give a test so that you understand where you stand. Using the create option, you can create your own flashcards, and in the library it has light flashcards, so you can keep doing them again and again for revision. And lastly, it gives you insights on your performance, basically how much time you studied for, what your progress is like. You are preparing for MCQ exams, which are basically short form answers, so you don't really need to go through all the long answers when you can simply use flashcards. So you definitely have to check out the Flash Prep app. It's completely free to use. You can check out the link in the description to download it from the App Store as well as the Play Store. And the last step to complete your economics ka syllabus would be to practice sample papers and past year papers, basically all the question papers you can get your hands on. So this is what you have to do in the fourth week of your studying. So basically, I gave you a plan of 1 month to complete your economics syllabus. Let me give you a summary of it again. In the first 2 weeks, you can read the chapter as well as solve the back exercise. So you will have a hang of the kind of questions that will come in the board exam. In the third week, you can start your revision by using flashcards on the Flash Prep app. And in the fourth week, you can start solving mock tests, sample papers, etc. Now I'm going to be telling you as to how you exactly have to study. मतलब chapters को कैसे पढ़ना होता है and कैसे retain करनी होती है सारी information. So first things first, you have to figure out your strengths and weaknesses in the subject of economics. I'm sure अब सबके schools में at least 1 to 2 tests तो हो ही गए होंगे. So you must have understood which chapters you're good at. If you're better at macroeconomics or you're better at Indian economics, which subject requires more practice and more studying basically from your end. So once you figured all that out, you will be able to allocate more time to specific chapters because you've understood ke where you are lagging behind. So for example, if you're not good at Indian economics, start studying that first. Now, once you've started studying, it's very important that you make sure that you're understanding each and every concept very well and you're studying all the chapters thoroughly, because in a subject like economics, especially macroeconomics, it's very, very important to understand each and every concept. Otherwise, it will be very difficult for you to get a 40 on 40 in your economics board exam. Do not leave any chapter pending and cover each and every topic, because again, in economics, they can ask you absolutely anything in MCQs, especially with assertion and reason. Assertion, reason mein zaruri nahi ke book se utha ke line denge. They could give you anything. So that's where the role of understanding concepts comes in. So make sure that you are reading the chapter once or twice and everything is actually going into your head and you're able to understand the chronology of things. But still, Indian economics mein bhi kafi logic use hota hai kabhi kabhi in assertion and reason. So make sure, along with remembering each and every information, you are understanding it as well. Now, if there are certain things that you're not able to understand in economics, it's very important that you go to your teacher and ask doubts, because there are concepts that may be difficult to understand, but your teacher can give you the right guidance and he or she will help you to understand the concepts very well. And if not that, you can easily refer to YouTube channels for explanations as well. Economics on Your Tips, Rajat Arora, CA Parag Gupta, like there are so many channels at this point, you can refer to any of them, but make sure that you are understanding them. Do not leave them thinking ki nahi mere se to nahi ho payega. Of course you can do it, but you just need a little bit of a push and help to help you understand everything in economics. Now, when you're studying economics, I understand that it could get boring at times, especially Indian economics, wo kafi boring hoti hai kabhi kabhi. So you should study in short time sessions with frequent breaks, because economics is a subject that needs you to be alert and understand everything. So whenever you feel tired or lethargic, take a small little break, drink water, walk around and come back to studying. But don't try to study in long sessions. Even for me, I never spent more than 1-1.5 hours continuously for studying economics, because obviously it gets a lot sometimes. There's too much information to process. So make sure that you're taking small little breaks. You can follow the Pomodoro method, where you're studying for 15 minutes and then you're taking a 10 minutes break. After following all these steps, I am pretty sure that after a month, you will be so good at economics ki tumhe baar baar padhne ki zarurat bhi nahi padegi. You'll easily be able to get through your board exams. So one last thing that you have to do that I mentioned earlier as well is practice sample papers. Apne maze mein MCQ papers solve karo in the last week and before the board exams, you will be good to go. And when you're solving sample papers, also try to sort of assess yourself and see where you're making the most mistakes. Is it Indian economics? Is it a specific chapter jiske questions tumhe nahi samajh mein aa rahe? Go back to that chapter, solve with flashcards, read the chapter again, maybe do the back exercise as well. But I'm sure once you complete this 1 month ka cycle of studying and solving sample papers, you will be able to get a 40 on 40 in economics. And yeah, that's all I have for you guys today. If you've made it till here, comment these emojis. I hope you found all these tips related to economics extremely helpful. In fact, you can use these tips for business studies as well. But don't worry, I will be coming up with a separate video for business studies so that you can study business studies effectively as well. So stay tuned for that video. And thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, then don't forget to hit the like button and also subscribe to my channel. Share this video with your friends, follow me on Instagram, and until next time, bye.